Okay, so let's go and do ourselves a quest, then. What should we do? Oh, that's part of the simulated universe thing. Well, fuck, I died in that right now. Suppose we could listen to what the young man from the Department of Galactic Geography has on his mind. Oh, this is that Rocky guy. Okay. Oh, he's right there. Should I make it witty? Nah, maybe sentimental is better. Elegance? Well, I probably shouldn't use idioms in a poem. Should I use dark silk or white gown here? Ugh, it's hurting my brain. What are you doing? Oh, I'm just writing a poem. Can't you see the drafts on the desk? I can't zoom in any closer. Oh, your interruption reminds me. How come Leslie still hasn't replied to my letters after all those poems I sent her? Who is Leslie? Oh, Leslie is a prominent researcher in the Department of Insight, the only scholar who has visited the Abundance Segmentum in this amber era. You sure she has time for you? Who's Bernard? Is that guy over there? Of course she does. Ever since Leslie left, we've been communicating on and off through the galaxy airwave repeater. She will never ignore me, even though we are tens of thousands of light years away. This is the only time she hasn't replied to me. I confess my love for her in my last letter. I usually just talk to her about the types of rock and mud that we see in Department of Galactic Geography. Brat. Show some respect to your own discipline, will you? I really don't understand why Leslie stopped answering me after I confessed my love for her. We used to chat about a lot of things, from which of the 101 Aeon instruments in the Department of Insight require Gunn's beard, too. And about how to use astro rods to examine the quality of soil, thus determining the rise and fall of the inhabitants of the planet. Bro, you are very romantic. Don't you mean bruh? Okay, ghosting, you might just be... Oh, ghosting you. Oh my god, okay, I'm having trouble reading right now. Ghosting you might just be her way of rejection. Who the hell talks about mud with a girl? Well, girls that like mud. That's impossible. If she were to reject me, why would she talk to me so much? Besides, during the communication where I confessed my love, she told me about a spectacular star quake. Think about it. A star died. Most people would try to hide it, but not my Leslie. Not only did she get first-hand observational data, she even saved a galaxy hitchhiker who almost died. You have no idea how happy she sounded in her reply. Even the airwave repeater signal was cheerful. Whenever I receive a reply from her, I can't help but picture the smile on her face that I'd carve into a rock. Before the Legion invasion, I had a bunch of rocks all lined up in a row on my desk. Unfortunately, they went missing in the chaos. Reckless romance. It's detrimental to your research. Anyway, there is no sign that she's going to reject me. If I don't receive her reply within the usual time frame, it means that there's must be something wrong with the galaxy airwave repeater. In my investigation, I found out that a group of Legion monsters occupied the area where the signals are transmitted. Can you help me find out what happened? Can you help me find out what happened to the airwave repeater? My master wouldn't let me go. Don't help him. All he thinks about is the airwave repeater. He hasn't done any proper work for more than 10 days. Shame on you. I'll help you. Nice. Don't listen to my master. If you have the time to listen to him, you would have found the galaxy airwave repeater already. Listen, the airwave repeater is next to the disposal site. It is a massive warehouse for storing discarded curios. You can resume our communication. I promise I'll reward you by inviting you to be our bridesmaid. Okay. Can probably do that. So, storage zone. Wait, is it above us or down below? Oh, it's up there. Oh, there's one of these bubbles. Might as well view it if we come across it. Bubbles are floating in the air. Yeah, we know. Touch. Today should have been your lucky day. Your department head, whose face is always as long as a fiddle, just raised your IPC rating to P30. You share the news with your mother, living in your faraway hometown, and her voice sounds excited on the other end of the communication device. You seem to hear her slimy body making a bubbling sound. What? A special philosophical... Psychological, okay. Or what is that? Physiological reaction of your Baviru race in moments of happiness. Oh, okay, it's slime race, I guess. You end the call and get on your brand new floating motorcycle. This baby costs 18 months of your salary, although it is pricey. It can soothe the trauma you have suffered in your workplace. You think it is worth its price tag, but it doesn't do much to your pain today. Should you tell your mother the truth, that the traditional project department is, in fact, a place for people to retire in and has no future? With a whimper, you twist the throttle to the max and dash into the aerial interchange lane in New Londinium. You like joyriding along the interchange lane. From here, the city looks like a tiny flickering candlelight on the mineral birthday cake, easily blown out. The troubles you face at work all fade away at that moment. The streets are deserted. You look up briefly at the news projected in the sky to find out the latest happenings in this bustling city. The face of the co-prime minister appears on the screen. Fine, you grumble, deciding to focus on the road ahead. Yet it is too late. The instant you return your attention from the clouds to the road, the engine of the floating motorcycle suddenly misfires and plummets to the ground out of your control. You just hope you won't land on Buckingham Avenue, or you will be fine. Wait a minute, is this Earth? To your relief, there is only an old shopping street with few pedestrians nearby, and your landing has hurt no one. Elderly couples who were happily chattering suffer a fright, but as soon as they realize you are nothing but a puddle of slime, they immediately clink their glasses in happiness again. What? I can't believe this, you bubble as you stare at the motorcycle reduced into a pile of burning wreckage. Not knowing what to do, you have no idea how far you are from your condo. You can only look up at the sky and ask for advice from the stars. But you hear the stars in the sky saying, even the poorest worker in the East New Londinian can't help but feel proud of the wealth we jointly own with the IPC. Okay. Investigate. Error, abnormal route, detachment protection activated, detected ultra nickel parts missing. I need to get the ultra nickel parts. Oh, they're in this place. Yeah. You guys are not going to live long enough to do that. Oh shit, I didn't attack it with a weakness.
Doke. Sawagi.
Kurukuru. Uchi te ba nakanaka yaru jan.
Nice. Alright, here's one. And what? Oh no, that's okay. Collect. Items obtained. Ultra nickel part. Investigate the communication history on the repeater. Airwave is online. Transmitting airwave has not been detected. If needed, please select the historical signal decoding record that you wish to review. 2157 AE, months 40 to 43. Oh god, please, no. Look, at one point, I kind of... Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay, fine. Signal log, 2157 AE, months 40 through 43. Source unknown light years exceeds detectable distance. Recipient, Herta Space Station, Rocky Martinez. Translated text below. Leslie, Herta Space Station system time, whatever the fuck. Hi, Rocky. Leslie. Okay, oh, I see. Okay, so that's who's sending it. Leslie. And then Rocky. Hi, Rocky. The Interastral Research Team has landed on a planet in the neighboring system into the Abundance Galaxy. The air is so refreshing here. Even though this place isn't actual Aeon's territory, it's already able to generate an extremely high degree of oxygen just by being so close to the Aeons. This is my first time witnessing whatever that is. I've always stayed inside the space station. Only reading about this is like living under a rock. The repeater signal is about to end. I feel like I said a lot of meaningless things. My bad. Don't forget to keep up the good work at the space station. Try your best to come out and see the stars soon. Just like the Hosea, who you admire so much. And now it's Rocky's response. Leslie, congratulations on your safe arrival. Don't worry, I scored excellent in the previous evaluation, and I'll definitely do it again next time. Leslie, what you said was very interesting. It's definitely not a waste of time. Tell me about everything you see. I'll be waiting to hear from you. Okay. This is months 44 through 47 from Rocky. Leslie, do you still have the astro rod I gave you? You said that it was difficult to use before. I looked through some ancient texts today and found a method for it. I've been eager to share it with you. Place the rod in the soil, straight and direct, straight as in not crooked, and straight as in not bent. Hold the rod with both hands and pierce it through straight into the dirt. Inspect the straightness. Use the mirror to focus the light. If the light reaches the bottom, then you're all set. If the light lands on the wall of the hole, then it is bent. Memorize it and tell me if it works. And now from Leslie. Ah, silly Rocky. Astro rods are so outdated nowadays. Hasn't the one you guys have at your old school or at your school also been sitting in the collections cabinet? All the tools the research team now uses to measure planetary soil are from the IPC. Well, seeing that it's the astro rod that you gave me, I suppose I'll try and figure out how it works. I believe digging up some precious rare earth elements with it shouldn't be a problem. Hey, aren't you always doing research with rocks? What's your favorite colored mineral? I'll try to look for it. And then from 48 to 51, from Leslie. Rocky, can you guess what I'm experiencing right now? The main star of the Abundance Segmentum experienced a gravitational collapse due to an unknown influence. Soon after, there was a star quake. Flashes in the universe and gamma afterglow fills everything in visible range. This is such a rare sight, the team member that promised to come with me before got scared and ran away. It'd be so nice if you were here. So don't be mad, okay? And then from Rocky, got scared and ran away? Good. From now on, don't accept any more gifts from that guy. It's obvious that he's unreliable. I'm not mad, I'm actually regretting our little argument. Oh, I guess they had an argument. You scared me to death when you said starquake. I thought something bad happened to you. But now I know. The beauties of a starquake is a result of its dangers. Let's go and watch it together next time. I will be right next to you even if it's dangerous. What I mean is, if possible, from now on, I'd like to always stay by your side. Do you understand what I'm trying to say? Oh, I see, okay. Next page. You can view the historical signal decoding record here. Months 52 to 55. No signal decoding record was found during this period. Did Leslie not reply? Oh, it doesn't say, okay. Months 56 to present. Rocky, how silly of you. Of course I understand what you mean. As for my answer, record is damaged. Well, isn't that just convenient? Cannot identify. Life form emotional fluctuation detected. Warning, you've entered the full surveillance area of the space station. Please do not conduct any inappropriate behavior towards the repeater. Airwave is offline. Go to the monitor room to take a look at everything that took place. Looks like someone has done something to the repeater. Where? Oh, Herta Space Station base zone. Okay. Okay, here we go. Boink, boink. Hello, authentication passed. Please choose the finest area you want to review. Master Control Zone Shift Station. Too rarely young researcher. Rarely young my ass. not the area I should be investigating. Base safe zone. During the time capture on the camera, the safe zone in the reception hall hasn't been set up. Nowhere to be seen, only the wandering monsters of the Legion. Isn't that March 7th and Dan? They look like they were in a hurry to do something. Forget it, the most important thing is to find the surveillance record of the repeater. Maintenance room. There's an old man. Clearly shows that someone is trapped in the repulsion bridge. Disposal site. Found it at last. Oh my god, is that... Oh my god, it's Bernard. It's the master dude. He's sabotaging the love. Medical cabin, what's in here? Ooh. Medical treatment. Okay, so now we gotta go... confront Bernard. Wait, what? What's up here? Identify the mastermind. Why is he suddenly up here? He was back there. I don't know what you're talking about. Young people should spend more time studying instead of wandering around. That sounds like something an old person would say. It's been captured while they sit on their ass doing fuck all. Although this guy, at the very least, looks like he's got something to answer for, to his name. It's been captured by the security footage. Why did you damage the record? I'll tell Rocky then. Why did you damage the record? Don't jump to conclusions. Show me your evidence. Thanks to you kids, I'm worried to death. I damaged the record for Rocky's own good. He's foregone his research because of that Leslie. Not to mention you have no idea what's happening right now. Leslie. Oh god, did she die? Well, how would he know though? How would he know that she died? No, she's safe and sound, and she said yes to Rocky's confession, but they can't be together. If you think I'm the one being difficult here, you are wrong. Don't get ahead of yourself. They can't be together. They never will be together. Do you know why? No, you don't. Well, then fucking tell me instead of saying that. People rarely understand what a starquake means. With proper protection, a starquake will not cause physical damage to humans. However, the gravitational collapse caused by a starquake will severely change the space-time curvature of the segmentum. For example, the time in Leslie's segmentum was once a starlight star... Once a straight line like ours, but now it has been pressed into a huge canyon by gravity. Clearly, a curve is always longer than a straight line. Therefore, the time curve of her segmentum is going to cover several times the length when converted to our timeline. Do you know what that means? The flow of time will be different. It means the velocity of our time is different from hers. Since the starquake, oh my god, this is getting brain... It is possible that the time it takes for her to reply to arrive will change from 1 month to a year and maybe even 10 years. This isn't just about her message, but everything she does. Until she leaves that abnormal gravity environment, every month she spends in the galaxy will equal decades for us. Let's say if Rocky, including us, is living at a point called the present, then in comparison, Leslie, she's living in the future. I used to be a young man once. In my opinion, not being able to be with someone you love is even more cruel than being rejected. Yeah, that's true. He old, but he do be speaking sense. At least tell him. Yeah, I think he should know. And then what? After knowing the truth, Rocky will have to wait 10 times longer for a message that should have arrived right away. Well, otherwise he's gonna sit here in the state that he's been for the past 10 days, Bernard. But how much time can he spend waiting? Maybe Leslie will finally return to the space station when he is old and decrepit like me. But the flow of time for her is so slow. Maybe at that time she'll still be as young as she is today. When that time comes, how are they going to be together? We may transcend space, but time is beyond our reach. You are way too young. You don't understand. Things that require a lot of waiting don't usually end up well. He will never give up if he doesn't know the truth. That's the thing. Naive kids. At first I thought if I damage the record, take away the parts and blame everything on the monsters, I could keep Rocky in the hope that one day the repeater will be repaired. Now since you have found out, the decision is up to you. I have 2 signal logs I copied from the repeater, red and blue. The red log contains Leslie's real reply, including the... Aw, why does the blue one have to be the fake one? I want to pick the blue one because it's blue. To be honest, even I can't imagine what Rocky will do after finding out the truth given how impulsive he is. The blue log is forged. in which Leslie refuses Rocky. Don't think about this as cruel. This way, Rocky won't have to wait for her reply in the future. He can just move on with his life. Well, it's cruel. Lying to him is cruel, period. Okay, so it's up to me then. Items, I've got it. Red one and the blue one. Tell the young man the truth or a lie. We're going to tell him the truth, because that's a shitty situation to be in. And it, I mean, yeah, if I was in his position, that would be really, really hard to learn that. But it would be way better knowing than being in the situation he's in right now. Because as somebody who does not handle situations like this waiting very well, I can tell you that the longer it goes on for, the worse it gets. So there's a paper here as well. Love poems. I wrote another poem called Praise Leslie. Did you fix the repeater? I see you're holding decoded backups. Which one is for me? The red truth. You seem hesitant. Are you sure the red one is for me? Yes, I am. Okay, I'll read it now. Thank you, bro. After some time. Can't believe it. Leslie said yes, but the starquake. I can't get my head around this. So, because of the gravitational effect of the starquake, every month she spends in her time will be decades for me. Am I going to be as old as my master when she's back? Is my interpretation correct? Fubuki, help me take a look. I'm a bit slow. Is that what she means? Oh, I was under the impression that it's... she'll be older. But I guess it swaps, it's the other way around. She's gone to the future, and I'm left in the present. Is this what happened? Oh my god, this is fucking brain. The decades I spend thinking about her will be only a fleeting moment for her, right? Who would have thought that even time can be so unfair? I guess it's unrealistic to hope that she will come back. Even if she travels for months and crosses light years, I will have become an old man in my time, spending my whole life waiting for someone and enduring endless longing and loneliness. Come on, bro. Do you really think I'm that naive? Of course I'm not going to wait for her. I won't. What, is he going to go looking for her? That's what I would do. I'm not going to wait for her, but I can go after her. Exactly. I'm going to chase after time. Since her time-space curve has become a canyon, wouldn't it be better for me to travel past this canyon instead of waiting for her to come back? Maybe it will take me 10 years to find her, who has only spent a month. But once I do, our time will be synchronized. It's better than sitting here and doing nothing. Don't you agree? No matter what you think, Fubuki, I've decided. I should inform my master as soon as possible, pack my things, and set off to my journey to find Leslie. I'm already tired of this place. As a member of the Herded Department of Galactic Geography, I haven't seen the real galaxy. Isn't it embarrassing? I'm sure you are just as curious as I am about the scenery in deep space. Boy, I tell you what, there is something waiting in deep space that makes me horny as hell. Spectacular words, enigmatic dangers, and the woman I am chasing after. When I find Leslie one day, I will come back and tell you everything I witnessed on my journey. By then, I will invite you to be our bridesmaid. Don't you forget it. While this poem is for you, goodbye, my friend. Darkness is gathering in the distance, using cruel methods. To dissect time, petals inquiring for love are falling, like the ticking chimes in an infinite time and space. We have no choice but to slide into the shivering calamities of the universe as if sliding down a slope into dusk. And with that, the stars continue their enjoyment above as their elegant smiles fill the way forward. Okay. Mission accomplished. The faint star mission completed. Okay, so... ask Asta what she needs you for. Alright, fine. That'll be our next task. I should be sleeping, but... Oh, fuck. Oh, shit, now my throat's making noises. I'm sorry, I'm not done. There's too much goddamn reading right now. I need a break. It's been a pretty long day. And it's quite late for me. Oh, no. Oh, no. 姿は見ないし、メッセージも返さない、通信にも応答しないの。
彼を連れ帰ってきてから今までこんなことはなかったわ。もちろんよ。でもアーランの行き先は監視映像でもわからなかったわ。監視システムはレギオンが侵入した時に破壊されてしまってまだ完全に復旧していないの。その盲点を突かれたのかもしれない。最後に連絡を取ってからもう13時間も経っているのよ。普段は13秒以内に返事をしてくれるのに。どうしても見つけることができなかったから防衛課の個人業務計画の記録を調べたの。そしたらこれを見つけたのよ。ほら、最後の業務目標を見て。心にチュンズル、鏡とカス、我を変えるってすごく変だと思わない？にこんな文才はないわ。はあ、防衛課に聞いてみたんだけど誰も緊急事態だとは思ってなかったの。それどころか
アーランの兄貴はもう大の男なんですから個人的な予定があってもおかしくないでしょう。
なんて言うのよ。
Oh, it's getting hot in here too.
彼らってば話が通じないの。だからこのことはあなたに任せるしかないと思って。なんで防衛課の人と同じことを言うの？冗談はいいから手を貸して。それに私には秘密武器があるのよ。
Oh, is it the dog?
それはペペ。
ペペ。
ええ、私の愛犬なんだけど、小さな頃からアーランが世話をしているから、彼ととっても仲良しなのよ。
Oh, okay, I see.
ペペはアーランの匂いをよく知っているから。彼を探し出すことができるかもしれないわ。うん、考えてみて。代理所長である私がこんなにたくさんいるスタッフの前でアーランを探したらどうなると思う？絶対にダメよ。防衛課の責任者である彼が頼りなく思われちゃうじゃない。ペペを連れて出発しましょう。安心して、ペペは噛まないから。
An unexpected turn of events. Okay, but I still need to talk to you about the other thing first. See you, thanks for helping out on the station. Did you encounter some problems? I heard you were looking for me. Yes, I want you to investigate the source of the mimetic. What? Okay. Mimetic virus that infected the crack-up conch. Crack-up conch? It's one of our curios. It looks like an ordinary conch, but when you get close, you can hear the dirty jokes coming from inside. We've seen that. As long as you hold your laughter, you can slowly obtain the secret power it contains. Of course, no one has succeeded so far, so we only use it. What are the dirty jokes? It's a kind of information particle that spreads around exponentially like a virus, which will bring changes and contamination to the host nature of thinking. Unfortunately, it can infect inanimate objects, and thus it changed the crack-up conch's external expression. It no longer... Oh my god, okay. Never mind. Like, get out of your comfort zone or you'll be wasted. Or, the pain you suffer will light up your way. Cliche quotes that just make people cringe. I had someone examine it and found that it was caused by the virus, but the crack-up conch... Oh, that's why it's called a crack-up conch, because it tells jokes, I see. Been properly stored all this time, which means it's possible for it to get infected on its own. The only possibility is that the workers who are already infected passed on the virus when they came in contact with the item. After I looked at the list of people who had recent contact with it, I identified three suspects. Well, I am sure you already know what I'm about to say next. I want you to investigate the three suspects for me. Fuck. Okay. I arranged for them to investigate as soon as I identified a list of subjects, but they all found nothing unusual. Since these suspects have spent a fair bit of time on the space station, they are pretty familiar with the security department. They might have gotten away with some possible misconduct. I, therefore, could not get any useful information. Okay, just let me leave so that I can go do my investigation portion. I don't need all this extra fucking explanation, damn it. Yes, I'm just salty because I'm tired and I don't want to keep reading right now. When you sit here and do these things for hours on end, it definitely exhausts me. Not the game's fault at all. Don't get me wrong. It's not the game's fault. It's just that it's late for me. And if it is not rocket science, you just need to walk up to them and listen and see if there's any unusual behaviors. If you find anything weird, just write it down and report it to me. So what do you think? Well, I would love to go. That's great. I'm so relieved that you're willing to help. I will reward you fairly. Let me think. Well, I don't know your taste. Why don't I pay for everything in your shopping cart out of my... Well, okay, I guess I'll just put as much expensive shit in my shopping cart as I can. Let me tell you about the three suspects. Mayor from the Department of Insight, Chris from the Department of Galactic Geopolitics, and then Joanne from the Medical Department. They usually stay in their own cabins. Given the station's current situation, I don't think they'll be anywhere else, so please help me take care of this. Okay, it only took us like four times to say that we need to go take care of this for it to actually let me go take care of this. Okay, there's Chris. He's right here. I think this is Chris. Let me observe his behavior. Hey, I'm talking to you. You! What are you doing? Why are you staring at me like that? Stay away from me. Oh, shit. I'm just passing by. I saw you peeping at me. I'm sure of it. What do you mean? You turned around and looked at me. Hold on. Why did you dye your hair like that? Did you do that to show off in front of me, trying to stand out from everyone else? And your clothes. Why don't you wear the uniform? Are you trying to show off your luxurious tailor-made outfit? I didn't dye my hair. No one else has hair like that. You think you are very special, huh? You just want to show off your privileges, such an attention seeker. Show off as much as you want. Don't try to act all innocent. I know exactly what people like you think. You think you are better than us. It's not enough for you to show off in the virtual world. You have to track me down and show off in front of my face. You think you are so rich that you can own the universe. Wait a second. What's that look on your face? Is there something in your eyes? You have a corneal contact camera? Why are you taking videos? Is this live? Oh, I get it. You are one of those people who likes to live broadcast your bullying behavior. Now, go away and leave me alone. Chris is very strange. I can't have a normal conversation with this person. He's such a paranoid. That's an interesting way of putting it. Why is there stuff that I haven't picked up here? Does stuff just spawn around the fucking place? Different notes and shit? Or did I actually miss that? Mare's right ahead. I better not alert her. I'll hide around here and listen to what she says. What the fuck? Ha-hoo! Am I doing this right? I feel like my pronunciation is not very good. I better keep practicing. Fluffy hair and strong limbs. If only I could touch it. Ugh. What kind of dirty ideas is this? Aw, how nice would it be if I could be their slave? Hiss. I just need to keep practicing, and one day I can. Mayor, you look much better lately, so the thing I told you about, it actually worked? Well, no, that's not the case. I'm sorry, I did try to look up what you mentioned, but I might have gone off track halfway. But yes, it's quite useful. It's just that, well, is there anything else? Well, there is something I want to ask you about. So I've been researching how Aeons are depicted in the mythological tales from different planets. Why are they depicted so differently? Some even have this so-called Leviathan worship. Leviathans can be pets too. Well, pets, there is a research report that I haven't finished working on yet, so I'll get back to you on later. Sure, by the way, I haven't seen you around lately. Did you go on an exotic field trip? Did you discover anything new? Can you tell me anything? Well, let's talk about this later. I didn't... Okay, I understand. You must be very busy since you just came back. Anyway, it's nice to see that you've recovered mentally. What? Okay. Doesn't sound like it to me. There's something strange about Mare. No shit. At first she was imitating some strange sounds, then when they talked about Leviathan worship, she looked very nervous. Okay, now... Did she come in contact with some kind of Leviathan during her research and got her mind contaminated? That's very strange. Base zone. It's a bubble. Joanne is right in front of me. Looks like she's talking to someone. There's nowhere to hide. I know, I'll just pretend I'm checking the medical services. Hey, Joanne, so surprised to see you are not still sleeping today. How rare. Maybe the blue has also started to orbit around the space station. The test results are out. I've sent them to you through the terminal. You may start the review process. My goodness, Joanne is actually working. Am I dreaming? You are only noticing this now? She's been 3 hours early for work for the past 7 days. That is exactly this. She's fucked up. She's the one that's all fucked up. Everyone else is normal. This is the fucked up one right here. Looks like you haven't been paying attention. Review countdown begins. 30 minutes left. I only took a few days off, and now our department has changed so much. I cannot believe it. Who turned you into this, Joanne? What happened to you? My guess is that it has something to do with department reform. The Interastral Peace Corporation has cut the medical research budget this quarter, and we are also impacted. I heard there would be a reform. It's not that unusual for people to try to get a high performance indicator during such turbulent times. You wouldn't want your research budget to be cut, would you? You're right, but I still need some time to digest all this. It's really unbelievable. Ha ha. The sleeping beauty of our medical department finally stopped sleeping and began to act on her duty as a doctor. No one's gonna believe this. Ha ha. 20 minutes left. I need to see the result of the drug test in 20 minutes. All right, got it. I'll get on it. Although Joanne looks normal, the way she speaks is very strange. Also, she showed up to work 3 hours early for like 20,000 days. She's emotionless when she talks, and her face looks stiff like a robot. Is there something wrong? I gotta report back to Ass. It's you. Thanks for helping out on the station. Did you encounter some problems? Tell her your observation thoughts. So all three of them sound unusual, but in theory there should only be one person who is infected. The principle behind it is actually quite simple. The viral load of informational particles left behind mimetic virus is the crack-up conk is simply not high enough. The viral load detected barely reached the amount that can be carried by an infected adult. So it's absolutely impossible for the crack-up conk to have contracted the virus from multiple individuals. But my investigation couldn't corroborate this. It's okay, I've got a backup plan. Virus is transmitted through virtual data, god damn it, and all the virtual data in the space station leaves traces in the terminal. Since we couldn't get much from our previous investigation, let's check the browsing records of the three suspects, and then we could... Okay. I've got an emergency plan for... Dude! Data exchange center. But I've never used a terminal. I've literally used terminals. Don't worry, it's simple. Enter the terminal room, verify your identity, and you can start your query. Simply put, anyone using any data gadget, which basically includes everyone on the space station, would have their behaviors recorded by the terminal. It is thus inappropriate for me or any other staff member to check such information. It's not like that I would have gone if I could. Think about it. Despite different backgrounds and identities, people on the space station have reached an agreement on personal privacy. The traces left from using virtual data can be found on the terminal. For example, from here, people can see all the unusual virtual platforms you visited during your working hours. Therefore, to respect everyone's privacy, no one, including myself and the other staff, should access the terminal. Think about it in their shoes. If you are in the space station staff, would you be happy with me going through your browsing records on the virtual network? Now you understand, right? That's why your special identity makes you the perfect candidate for this. Oh, for Christ's sake! Yes! I get it! I don't need more dialogue options that act like I don't fucking know what the hell she's trying to get at. God damn it. I'm not actually pissed off. No, okay. I'm literally just, my patience is running out for the dialogue that keeps going on and on and on. I get it, okay? Heroic deeds and your special identity. From an objective point of view, you are an outsider on the space station. You are not familiar with most people here, so it's unlikely that you hold any personal grudge against anyone. Not every outsider has a right to access the data records, but you are different. You are the hero who saved the space station. People trust your moral character. But of course, if you do decide to help, I hope you will keep everything you see strictly confidential. No problem, my lips are sealed, except it'll be on YouTube. Anyway, keep it secret while you're still in the space station. As for where you go or what you do in the future, it's none of my business. Before you leave, let me tell you how to use the terminal. As you know, the invasion on the station severely damaged the whole data center, and the server room where the terminal is housed is no exception. Despite our best efforts, the damage is yet to be fully remedied. What? Oh, for fuck's sake. The engineer would turn on the optical identity verification program manually every day to check whether the bioelectricity of each visitor entering the room is normal, thus ensuring that the terminal room is not invaded. Since the optical identity verification program is refreshed dynamically after it is turned on every day, you need to re-verify your identity every time you enter. For more details, please consult the maintenance engineer. I've told the engineer that you have permission to enter the room, so I will leave the rest to you. Well, that is fan-fucking-tastic. Okay. Let me see here. So this is this still the same one? Yeah, okay, this is still the same one. Wait, what? Oh, I don't have a scroll bar right now. Oh, God, this is difficult. I don't have any power stuff, do I? Yeah, I don't. I've got enough for one run thing. I'm trying to see. I just want to get to level 15, man. It can't be that much of a problem. Unfortunately, because it's late for me and I'm exhausted at the moment, and there's so much reading in this game, reading for hours in a Let's Play where I'm already doing commentary exhausts me quite a bit more. So I'm just trying to find something to boost my level, just ever so slightly. Yeah, see, I'd get it if I could finish this, because that's 600 frickin' juice right there. I mean, we could try it again. I could try it one more time, maybe, and just really go out at the end. Then I can do my polls, and then I can actually start setting up characters. We'll see. Let me see here. Let's see. Because I do have some stuff here that I could use. No, I don't want to do that. God damn it, holding it doesn't get rid of it. That's not what I want. I want, how do you superimposition it? Oh, right here, okay. Auto add. What does that do? Well, it doesn't actually tell me what it's gonna raise it to. What? 42%, okay. Okay, going up to 30, what? I guess it just went up to 35% overall, fine. Shit. Fuck, I guess I can try it again. I don't know if I'm gonna kill it, because they pretty much knocked us out. And I didn't really get them close to being defeated. And is it the whole thing I have to go through again? Which is fine if that's the case, but it looks like it is, yeah. Recommended types. Yeah, well, I've only got one of each of those. I don't have one of those. What is cached character data? Oh, okay. Shoot, I suppose I can try it. Yeah, 15, 15, 20, 20. Recommended team level is 16. I'll try it once, I suppose. One more time. Fragmented cosmic fragments. Blessing. Yeah, I want the blessing. So, since it's those two guys at the end, as much as I was really liking the follow-up damage boosts, I'm only going on that particular boss fight, I'm only going to get literally two follow-up attacks in total. That's all I'll get out of that. So it's not really going to help me. That's what I need to prepare for, is that fight. So, increase the damage of follow-up attacks by 9% for each of the... blessing. Right after an enemy is frozen, the next one attack launched against said enemy will have 100% increased crit rate. This effect is dispelled when the frozen state is removed. Okay, I'm going to prepare for that particular boss fight. Take us a little bit to get there, but we'll give it a try. If we lose again, then maybe I will just have to buff up some of my characters a little bit more just to prepare for it, but... Dead. Okay. Let's see. Increases the crit damage of shielded characters. After a character launches a follow-up attack, there's a 65% chance to recover one skill point. That's kind of neat. After a character is attacked, they gain a shield that can absorb damage equal to 18% of the HP lost during this attack, lasting for one turn. I'm going to go for that because they basically knocked us out because they basically both do two attacks. Destructive Impulse, it's just for destroying stuff. So anything to just prolong my character's survivability in that fight will be helpful. Okay, next one. Increase the max damage that can be absorbed by shields created by characters by 30%. That sounds great. Upon entering battle, there's a 150% chance. Yeah, okay, I'm going to go for that shield increase one. I know it's not one that I don't even have right now. I'm just trying to beat that first boss. So. Character's effect hit rate increases. What is an effect hit rate? After characters launch follow-up attacks, increases speed by 16% for one turn. After applying weakness break on an enemy, characters gain a shield that can absorb damage equal to 14% of their max HP. Go ahead and take this one. Not sure how useful it'll be, but I'll take it. Shit. Okay. I'm gonna have to refresh it because she's gonna take her turn and it'll remove her shield when she does. Alright, do your worst.
Yeah, that hurt. Hurt my shield.
Ow. Ow. But this guy's kicking our ass compared to the first time we fought him, I'm pretty sure. I don't remember getting hammered so hard. Okay. I don't think he's gonna last through one more turn. Yeah, no, I'm gonna use this just to be safe. Oh my god, he's gonna survive? No, okay. Jeebus. That's close. At the start of the battle, characters gain a special shield that can absorb damage equal to 1% of their max HP. Whenever another shield is gained, this special shield will also strengthen an equal value. For every 2 turns, this will be removed, and then the special shield can be regained. What? Okay, I think I get it. When attacking frozen enemies, there's a 100% chance. Okay, that's that thing again. I'm going for anything that has shield protection, especially at the start. Not that it's going to be that great, but it'll help. Okay, so here's what I want to do here. I want to use this. Use it again. And then refill, because I think you always get 2 out of that. Okay. And you. Yes. 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 Okay. So, we've got divine, all characters. Wow, okay. Upgrading this will take it from 1% of max HP to 10% of max HP, strengthened by 130%. So I will spend it on that. Okay. Into the next battle. Main combat. Oh, shit. Try me, bitch. Yeah.
Do.
I didn't do any damage to her shield. Damn. Guess that's that toughness at work. What? Excuse me. Oh, I didn't know they had tick damage on. 12 Monkeys and Angry Men. I remember that one. Let's see. Characters gain a 6% defense increase for each preservation blessing. Can I see? Check obtained blessings. So it's preservation stuff. How do I know? Divine construction. Blessings of preservation. Oh, I've got 3 preservations already. So I might even want to take that. When a character uses their skill or ultimate, okay. When a character deals damage to an enemy with a follow-up, okay, I'm going to take this one. Give me as much protection as I can. I'm really trying to prepare for that final fight. Because it's going to be a total slog to get through, and we just need to survive.
Okay,
attack boost. Damn it, I thought that would kill it. Oh, that'll kill that one, I guess. Shoot. Yeah, fuck it. I didn't see what that said. It went by really fast. It said energy something or other. Okay. Next, what do we get from this? Increases the weakness of break efficiency of follow-up attacks. When a character, after applying weakness break on an enemy, character gains a shield that can absorb damage. I don't know how this stuff stacks, but I will take it. It's another preservation thing anyways, so I'm going to get a defense increase. I don't know what defense increase does. I'm assuming it just means you take less damage. That would be my best guess. Holy shit. So that thing's a buffer, I guess. Yes, I do know that I've got more bursts, but I don't remember when the boss fight's happening, and I don't want to miss it. Oh, it does attack, okay. That's not doing all that much damage, even with that little bit of shield, and then we get a little bit of shield back. Okay, that did an incredible amount of damage. After saying that it wasn't doing a thing, attacks weren't doing much damage. Dude! Okay, energy regeneration. So when it explodes, we get like a buff, I guess. After an enemy receives ice damage, enemies adjacent to it also receive damage equal to 20% of the damage taken to the target enemy. That actually sounds great. After a character launches a follow-up attack, increase the damage taken from... Okay, that might be good, so that my burst might actually do a little bit of extra damage to enemies. Currents. Damage taken increases crit rate of follow-up, increases the weakness break efficiency of follow-up. Oh, these aren't, none of these are really great. Pick that one. Okay, is this the boss fight room? This is it, okay. Well, I'm not sure if I'm feeling too good about this, but I'll try it. We'll see. Open the enhance screen. Give me what I can. I don't have a lot that I can do here, but... I'll be able to do one of these, and that's it, I think. Yeah, I can't do the little one either. All right, guys, this is it. Here we go. Oh, I wish it would tell me. Tell me what does it mean when I Z? Does it tell me what happens if I, what depending on what I choose to hit it with, weakness-wise? How do I find that? Is it in tutorials? Combat? Select target? No. Skill point? No. Action order? No. Ultimate weakness? Okay. Shield weakness break? Oh, here we go. Weakness break physical. Will deal physical damage and apply the bleed effect. Ice will freeze. Okay. Oh, shit. Okay, fine. I'm gonna try freeze. Now, don't start by, like, attacking me a shitload. No, it wants to start by attacking me a shitload. Okay, it's just the one guy that's attacking you. Alright. Okay. Not apply my thingy I wanted. Oh, he takes a little damage. Okay, thank God. Didn't do any actual physical damage. That's good. This is what I was hoping for. Okay. Damn it, still not. Fuck it, okay. Hit him with it regardless. Because it'll have to regenerate anyways. That way I'm doing a little bit extra damage. I'm still gonna try to take this guy down, but... try to keep shields running as much as I can. That's what's gonna get us really hurt. Single attacks my shield can hold up against. Okay, he's back in working order now. Oh God, we're like barely doing anything to him. And oh shit. Fuck. Okay, Herta's gonna lose her shield in the next. Her turn. Although she's got a. She's got two shields. I don't know which one she's losing, but. And they're gonna take two turns. They're both going to go for a turn. Ow. Yeah, okay, they're targeting the one that just lost her main shield. Two of them are frozen? Oh, God, okay, we're gonna lose again. It's taking way too long. They get to take turns again? Why? What the hell, man? My turns were coming up. I was watching the list. Okay. I can try this. No, we're not doing enough damage. They're doing way more damage than we can do to them. Oh, that's what's killing us, is their fucking AoE attacks. Because I can't, not all of my characters have the shield. And then he does another one. And it goes, oh no, I didn't lose her, I thought I was going to. She's going to die because of her flames, though. I guess I can put another shield on her. What do I do? Shit. No, there's nothing I can do. He's gonna do the AoE attack again. I didn't lose two characters. I almost lost two characters. I lost two characters. I'm not gonna get a chance to actually do any attacks if I have to keep putting my shield up, though. Oh, I guess I can build energy just to do this over and over. Why does he get to go again? That's not fair, man. Oh, then she kills me anyway. Well, there was no way I was gonna win with just freaking March. Because I might, yeah, sure, I could keep popping her shield until I run out of my skill point things. Which I had run out of my skill point things. I don't get it. I was preparing for that, and I thought we had like a good setup with all of our shield buffing and stuff, and yet they still, like I said, it's the AoE attacks, because I can only have so many shields at one time. Because by the time I get around to putting up another shield, the other one, the first one, is running out on that same turn. And so there's always somebody that's going to take a shitload of damage. And because there's two of them, and because they're both really tough, they both take their turns back to back. So I lose one. And the freezing is also hurting me, because my characters would get frozen. I mean, I still got points, I guess, for trying, but that's not going to help me. I just want my freaking level so that I can do this with a set of characters. Well, great. I mean, hey, I got a pull on it. Does that put me up to what I need? No, probably not. I also got an achievement. What did I get? Something. Destroy 100 destructibles and use technique 50 times. I also got break 20 destructibles in simulated universe and unlock 12 blessings of preservation in simulated universe. That's pretty neat. Speaking of, did I unlock anything new over here? Reward-wise, yes I did. Take that, thank you. Warp. Let me see. And yeah, I'm four short of having enough to do this. I don't want to do it just with four that I'm missing. That would be balls, man. Well, actually... Oh, I don't have any... I might actually be able to do it. Because, assuming that it works like Genshin, you'll get dust. And then I can use the dust on the store for that thing that has the five... Yeah, right here. There's five left. Assuming I get enough dust, I can get these and then just do the rest of the pulls. Well, shit, maybe I can do it then. Okay, let's do one more video for today. But other than that, I'm going to sleep. Like, holy shit.